All right, here once again is the latest forecast cone of Isaias as it becomes potentially a hurricane sometime on Friday through the Bahamas. And it is going to run into some limited factors with a little bit of shear. So its chance to get even stronger than a Category 1 is limited. But we are going to see that forecast for tomorrow night, within the next 24 hours, becoming a Category 1 hurricane. If we could go back to Doppler 1, I would appreciate it. Behind me on the wall there, Doppler 1, please. We are going to see the slide up the East Coast and just a little bit. There we go. Thank you. Just about a mile or two is different from the 5 o'clock advisory as it continues to pull off to the East Coast. Now, remember, this cone only tracks where the center of circulation could be. So if it tracks more westerly, we're going to have a much different looking Saturday than if it goes farther to the east. The trend as of late is that it is trending off to the east and potentially becoming a little bit stronger. That would work in our favor of becoming a quieter weekend. But I'll tell you what, the hurricane hunters are in there right now. They're finding some pretty strong winds. So we will have an update probably at the 2 o'clock advisory in the morning of what kind of strength they're seeing. And then a big update at 5 a.m. with a new forecast code using this information and with brand new computer model run. So as the forecast looks as of now, and the fact that it is staying consistent with what it was like at 5, let's go forward with this forecast and see what our weekend's going to look like. We have tropical storm watches in place for the East Coast. That's a hurricane watch just offshore. What would the winds look like? Well, we're talking about 15, 17 mile per hour winds during the day on Saturday out of the northeast, and then turning out of the northwest on Sunday to about 10 to 15 miles per hour, gusting a little bit higher than that. So as far as the winds are concerned, a breezy day with a few gusts of wind. Imagine feeling that thunderstorm starting to brew during the afternoon, but kind of all day long. So it's not going to be a day where we need to hunker down and put up the storm shutters. It would be a breezy day as the forecast holds now. Know that this forecast is subject to change. What would the rain situation look like? Well, for tomorrow, quick look at tomorrow's forecast. Just a few isolated showers like what we had today. So imagine we have cloudy skies, breezy conditions, 10, 15 mile per hour winds. And as we head through the afternoon, gusting up to near 20, especially for areas around the lake, that's where it would be breeziest, closer to that tropical storm or hurricane Isaias. Now we're just getting some afternoon showers working their way in, maybe a little bit more during some periods of the day. The timing of this won't always hold to the afternoon because it's when that moisture kind of streams on into our region. And then on Friday, another round of scattered showers. So if the forecast were to hold where we have that storm moving just offshore of the East Coast, it would mean for us a breezy weekend, specifically on Saturday, cloudy, maybe temperatures a little bit lower than what we're used to seeing, and some scattered showers, maybe just an inconvenient day. And that's as long as the forecast does not push farther to the west. That would mean higher winds, maybe more rain, and that would be an adjust that we would have to keep you up to date with. But for tomorrow, tomorrow's going to be hot, 96 degrees. We don't have any influence from Isaias tomorrow whatsoever. Actually, the only influence that we do have is because we're on the opposite side of it. We're getting a little bit of air going down, suppressing. So it's hard for us to get those showers to go tomorrow. We'll have a few like we had tonight, but not that many. 91 on Saturday. As the forecast holds now and the timing of it holds now, if we were to see that influence of a breezy day with some scattered showers, Saturday would be more of an impact than Sunday as that forecast or as that storm starts to push off to the north. And then we get back to our routine summer pattern by next week. That's your first alert forecast.